Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In addition to the shrine of Muslim bin Aqil and Mukhtar al-Thaqafi within the precincts of Masjid al-Kufa, we have the shrine of Hani ibn Urwa, this great companion and supporter of Amir al-Mu'mineen, salawatullahi wa salamahu alayh. The narrations mention that historically speaking, when Muslim bin Aqil came to Kufa, at one point of his revolution, which was nipped at the very early stages, you find that Muslim bin Aqil was sheltered in the house of Hani ibn Urwa. When Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad, through his spy's network, had found out that Muslim bin Aqil was residing at the house of Hani ibn Urwa, Hani ibn Urwa was brought to Darul Imara for interrogation. And Hani ibn Urwa was a man where historians record was close to about 90 years of age. Despite his old age, you find that he still had the heat of the love, this heat which emanates from the love of Ahlul Bayt within him, that at the age of 90, he played a central role in the revolution of Muslim bin Aqil, and he played rather a forefront role in the revolution of Muslim bin Aqil. The historians mentioned that as soon as the spy agency and the network found out that Hani ibn Urwa was sheltering Muslim bin Aqil, Hani was then brought to Darul Imara for interrogation. Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad asked Hani ibn Urwa about the whereabouts of Muslim bin Aqil, who was by then a wanted man with a bounty on his head. At this point, Hani ibn Urwa refused to disseminate any information. The narrations mention that Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad began to hit Hani ibn Urwa, a 90-year-old man, with a metal rod on his face repeatedly, to the extent that he broke the nose of Hani ibn Urwa. He hit him on his forehead with this rod to the extent that he began to bleed excessively. He began to beat him on his face, such that it is mentioned that the skin from his cheeks were hanging over his beard due to the intensity of his beatings. Hani endured all this persecution, all this torture in the name of Ahlul Bayt, in the name of protecting Ahlul Bayt, protecting Muslim bin Aqil, because to protect Muslim bin Aqil at that moment meant or translated into protecting Imam al-Husayn. And it is in this manner that Hani ibn Urwa was also beheaded, and together with the corpse of Muslim bin Aqil, his corpse was also tied to a horse and was dragged around the cities of Kufa. We come here to pay tribute to Hani ibn Urwa, and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to inspire us to follow within the footsteps of Hani ibn Urwa, in that we may be an ounce of what Hani was when it comes to showing loyalty towards Ahlul Bayt. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.